There are a lot of ways that I think when we see a figure like Tyler Perry, for example, today, or Spike Lee, they're not just filmmakers, but they're also really trying to speak to the most important issues facing the audiences that they are speaking to. And Oscar Micheaux was doing that at the beginning of the 20th century. The silent period is an important cultural moment because it's a moment that is characterized by racial discrimination in the United States. The most significant American film released during the 19-teens was D.W. Griffith's The Birth of a Nation. It was really a cultural phenomenon. And this is a film that glorifies the Ku Klux Klan and talks about the ways in which the South was slipping and in danger of a rising Black population after slavery. Micheaux wanted to respond to the kind of thinking that made that film possible and made it so popular. His film, The Symbol of the Unconquered, for example, shows the Ku Klux Klan and the way that these night rides were intended to really terrorize Black people and make them afraid to pursue the American dream, and really delves into the reasons why they have so much anxiety about the idea of a successful Black population. He wasn't just responding to racism in mainstream films, that he was also reflecting these cultural traditions from the Black community. He was very much invested in giving his audiences more positive and more realistic images that they could feel a connection to. There's a really powerful score that the jazz drummer Max Roach, who is one of the legends in the jazz world, created for Oscar Micheaux's film. And the score consists only of him playing drums. And so he gives us these real powerful nuances of sound, sometimes quite bombastic, other times really soft and subtle. And then he actually makes the drums go completely silent. And for a few moments, we really take in the profound nature of the violence and the threats that we're seeing on screen. Silent films actually offer this really powerful and unique canvas for contemporary musicians to think about how it is that their practice can keep these films relevant for audiences today. And they serve as a way of creating collaborative opportunities between artists across a century.